Stock market continued up in the month of May. The stock market, from a broad perspective, is up overall, but why? That's the big question. And we've got an inverted yield curve, and I'm going to take you through that in detail so that you can see what that yield curve did day by day. Please stick around for the monthly economic update. Hello, everybody. I'm Dean Barber. Welcome to the Modern Wealth Management Monthly Economic Update. No shortage of crazy things happening out there right now. We're going to dive into the yield curve once again, and we're going to dig into what's driving these markets higher. And as I do this monthly economic update, it is May 31st, so the last day of May, and summer is on the way. So I want to start out with the yield curve. We've been going over the yield curve a lot lately, but I want to show you the dramatic shift in the shape of the yield curve just in the month of May. So as we start out here, you can see that this is May the 1st. And so we had our 1 month treasury down here at about 4.49%. And then I'm going to focus on the 10-year treasury over here. And the 10-year treasury at the beginning of the month was 3.59%. So I'm just going to take this one day at a time, and we'll move forward on this yield curve chart. So you start to see that daily the shape of the curve changes. It took just 3 days for the 1 month treasury to jump up to 5.76%, and it stuck around that 5.5% mark for the balance of the month. Check this out. So the 1 month treasury is the highest yielding treasury for all but 3 days in May until we get to just the last couple of days here. And you'll see the 1 month in the last couple of days, no longer the highest yielding. Now we've got the 3 month on May 30th at 5.55 and the 4 month at 5.64. The 10-year, 3.69, 1 month, 5.31, and the 3 month being the highest treasury on May the 30th at 5.55. So once again, this inverted yield curve still tells us that there's the high likelihood that a recession is around the corner. You might say to yourself, okay, so if a recession is around the corner, what in the world is going on with the stock market? The stock market's up this year. If you look at the broad markets, the S&P 500 is up nicely. We'll go into the numbers here in just a minute. The NASDAQ is the leading index that is up. And let's take a dive in here. So if we just look on a year-to-date basis, I've got here year-to-date. Let me sort this for year to date. The NASDAQ 100 is up 31.43% on a year to date basis. S&P 100 up 15.41 and the S&P 500 up 9.87. Look at the NASDAQ up 8.63% in the month of May alone. Now, there's something strange going on here, and it's visible if you take a look down here at the RSP equal weight. The equal weight takes all of the stocks in the S&P 500 and weights them equally in that ETF. So the S&P equal weight is actually down by 0.29% on the year, while the S&P 500 is up by 9.87%. So take a look at this. Apple makes up 7.24% of the S&P 500. Microsoft, Amazon, Nvidia, Google, Berkshire Hathaway Class B shares. So here's the thing. If you take these six stocks, Apple, Netflix, Amazon, Meta, Microsoft, Tesla, and we can add Nvidia into that as well, they actually account for 120% of the S&P 500's return so far this year. So we've got six or seven stocks driving the entire market. That means everything else is down. So this is shaping up to look like a tech bubble that is surrounded by all of the mania over the artificial intelligence. Now, every single time we've had tech stocks go up this fast, it's ended in something that is not so nice. You look at NVIDIA, for example, because that's one of the ones that has been in the news a lot lately. The price to earnings ratio on NVIDIA right now is 201. That means it's trading at 201 times next year's forward-looking earnings. That's insane. Okay? So when you have a stock market that is moving higher, driven by only a handful of stocks, that means there's trouble other places. So could that tech bubble continue to rise? Absolutely. Could it go higher than it is today? Absolutely. But does it mean that we should take all of our money now and let's shift it into the technology sector, or let's shift it into the NASDAQ 100? No, it does not mean that at all. What it means is if you have some money in those particular areas and you've got some nice profits on those this year, you might want to think about rebalancing. You might want to think about taking some of those profits off the table, especially if you own those individual stocks. The real story here is, you know, and we're here on the 31st of May, we still don't know what's going to happen with the debt ceiling. I say it gets passed, and I'll either be proven right or wrong by the time you're watching this video, but there's a lot of noise around that. We've been there before. It's created a lot of hype in the market, but I think the one thing that's really driving the markets right now is the technology stocks, and it's just a handful of them. So it's very, very narrow, and typically that does not set up well for this being the beginning of a new bull market. What I believe we're in right now is a cyclical bull market inside of a longer-term secular bear market. I still anticipate quite a bit of volatility throughout this year, so kind of buckle up, hang on. But take an opportunity to really sit down with your financial advisor here at Modern Wealth and talk to us about your appetite for risk, and let's review the plan, and let's make sure that the plan is still on track. And if we're able to reduce risk in your portfolio without reducing your probability of success in your plan, this would be a time to have that type of a discussion. I do believe that there will be opportunities in the future, but I think right now, is as we sit today, you really have more of a headwind for stocks and you have more of a tailwind for bonds. So asset allocation is still the key. I don't think we're going to wind up in a year like we had in 2022 where both stocks and bonds got hammered. I think the worst for bonds is far behind us. And I think as a recession looms in the future, that could spell difficulty for stocks, but it could also spell opportunity for bondholders. With that, I encourage you to stay in touch with us. Talk with your certified financial planner, your advisor here at Modern Wealth, and we'll answer any questions that you have. Thank you so much for joining me for the Modern Wealth Economic Update. Thanks for making it to the end of the video. Don't forget, we also have our educational series and we have America's Wealth Management Show with new episodes released every Monday and Thursday. All can be found on YouTube. Make sure and check those out and subscribe. Give us a thumbs up. And as always, make sure you share with your friends.